An issue often encountered in the lubrication equipment industry is old products with outdated designs. The perception is often that it ain't broke, so no need to fix it. Often the product is antiquated and desperately needs an update, but if there's no competition, then there's no innovation. So that's where Graco comes in, with the drop-in upgrade. Allow us to introduce you to the Dyna-Star 200-to-1 high-pressure pneumatic pump. In this presentation, we will focus on the pump performance curves of this pump and how the performance compares to the pump that has been offered for decades by our largest competitor. Even in an industry that likes the tried and true products over newer designs that they perceive as unproven, the Graco engineering team has time-tested designs and decades of experience with all kinds of fluids, especially grease. The Mercur air motor has been in use at Graco for over a decade. It's based on our NXT air motor design, which is even older. So when I say this motor is legendary, I mean that it's field proven and tested by time. We use these air motors to pump abrasive paints, sticky adhesives and sealants, and all sorts of other nasty materials. So grease is a piece of cake for this beast. And now to the performance curve chart. Most people see a chart like this and say, "Oh no, a gosh darn performance curve. These things are too confusing for me." But the first thing to know is that this is really two charts in one. We can remove the gray lines because they are for air consumption, and we'll be ignoring them for now. Also, we're just going to focus on the 100 PSI performance because that's the maximum pressure for our Mercur air motor. So now, at maximum air pressure, we can see that at 20,000 PSI, there is no flow from the pump. That's called the stall pressure. Next, let's find the mark that indicates 16,000 PSI of outlet pressure and follow it to the right. When we draw a horizontal line over from this point, it intersects our pump performance curve right here. Now, when we draw a vertical line straight down from that point, we see that the flow rate at 16,000 PSI is just a hair over 0.16 gallons per minute because each of these ticks represents another 0.02 GPM. 0.16 GPM converts to about 37.5 cubic inches per minute. So since we are a bit past the 0.16 mark anyway, let's just round that up to 38 cubic inches per minute. Keep this number in mind and we'll get back to it in a moment. We will show a comparison of our 200-to-1 pump to the competitor's design in a moment, but first let's talk about its performance. The first big difference is the maximum air pressure. This pump has a maximum air pressure of only 80 psi, while our pump is rated for 100 psi. Since they state their ratio as 250-to-1 and the maximum air pressure is 80 psi, we should be able to multiply 250 times 80 and get the stall pressure. 250 times 80 equals 20,000 PSI, which is the theoretical stall pressure. But theory is one thing and the real world is another. In the real world, our competitor's pump stalls at around 18,500 PSI in one direction and only 16,000 PSI in the other. So after it exceeds 16,000 PSI, you might get a half a stroke more out of it, but then on the changeover, it's going to stall until the outlet pressure drops below 16,000 PSI once again. The definition of a pump ratio is the outlet stall pressure divided by the inlet air pressure. So when we divide each of these stall pressures by 80, the real world ratio of this pump is either a hair over 230-to-1 or exactly 200-to-1, depending on which stall pressure you choose to base it on. Because 18,500 divided by 80 is slightly over 230, and 16,000 divided by 80 is exactly 200. Now let's copy and paste the information from the two separate performance charts so that we can compare the pump curves head to head. Here's our 100 PSI line for the Dyna-Star 200-to-1, and here is the competitor's performance curve at maximum pressure for their high pressure pump. At 16,000 PSI back pressure, the competitor's pump will deliver half a stroke and then stop. But even before it stops, the flow rate would be just shy of 0.07 GPM, which is roughly 16 cubic inches per minute. Now recall from a minute ago that the Dyna-Star 200-to-1 delivers 38 cubic inches per minute at 16,000 PSI outlet pressure and maximum inlet pressure. That's more than twice the flow at 16,000 PSI. We could do the same thing at 10,000 PSI outlet pressure. There's already this dotted line, but let's make it more clear. The competitor's curve hits the line just past 0.31 GPM, and ours is right around 0.41 GPM at 10,000 PSI. So about one-third more flow. Now, you might look at the right side of this chart and say, hey, wait, at 7,000 PSI, it looks like the performance curves will cross. And you'd be right. But no one uses these pumps at 7,000 PSI. If that's all that's needed for the application, you're going to use a different pump. One detail that has not been stated yet is that both pumps have the same output per stroke. And now we've already shown you that the two pumps have functionally the same ratio, but because our pumps have a higher air pressure rating, we can pump more grease. This means that it takes us less time to pump the grease that you need, and that means that you get more frac stages per day because you spend less time waiting on your grease pump.